After selling off hard over the summer, many of the cloud-based software stocks, well, they've started to come roaring back in the fourth quarter. Take Anaplan, which has a software-as-a-service platform that helps businesses with forecasting and financial planning, something that's very useful in an increasingly uncertain world. Thanks to its recent move, Anaplan stock is now up more than 90% for the year, even as it's still down $9 from its highs over the summer. I think it could have more room to run, as the company just reported its very strong quarter a few weeks ago. So let's take a closer look with Frank Calderoni. He's the chairman and CEO of Anaplan to get a better sense of how his company's doing and where it's headed. Mr. Calderoni, welcome back to Mad Money. Good to see you, Frank. Have a seat.
Great.
All right, Frank, I saw you right on the eve of the IPO, and I remember they were pricing it around $17. And I know your background, and I knew the business plan. And I said to myself, how do they arrive at a price of 17 with this man who is going to drive this company's growth? How did that happen? Because in many ways, that's the kind of bargain that people really need to find.
Well, that was over a year ago.
Okay.
And I thought it was a great price from a timing perspective for our shareholders at the time, the VCs right. that were investing in the others that were investing in the company, and then also from a market perspective. The best thing I felt kind of going through the whole process was you want to make sure you get the right balanced price.
Right.
So you have an ability to kind of then go into a public market, show the results, and see some of the improvement. I think over the past year, as you said, we've had now four quarters since the IPO that we've been able to deliver consistent and growing top line and also improvement on our bottom line, which is a good message.
And this is really important, people. The billings accelerator, they were already at 46%. You hit 59%. Frank, how does someone go from 46% to 59% acceleration?
Yeah, I think it's kind of the space that we're in right now. I mean, if you kind of think about the backdrop and also, you know, SaaS companies in total, the whole digitization is really starting to accelerate. You know, and this is a global phenomenon. I was in Japan over the summer too, and it was interesting to kind of see where the Japanese companies are really kind of advancing their focus on digitization. So I think that as a backdrop is forcing companies to take a different look at what they're doing on the planning space.
Right.
And so we're taking it. We've got a great platform that we can offer great value in a reasonable amount of time for companies to implement Anaplan and then also accelerate. And that's really what's driving our growth. We're increasing the number of customers. The customers that we currently have are continuing to add right. to the use of Anaplan within their companies. And so that's great to see.
Okay, so of the three that I thought were most significant, you have giant pharmaceutical company, drug development company, I should call it, a huge airline. And I know that you knew Red Hat, you knew Jim Motors from Delta. Before,
yes, right? Yes, yes.
And then you also have, I thought was really interesting, was a customer in the consumer packaged goods space. Now, I'm thinking all these different, do things change enough at these different companies that someone has to update the plan every day?
So, you know, I think some people feel like planning is something that you do on an annual basis, which
right.
you do, and you may update on a quarter.
I've been in a lot of lousy companies, that's what we do.
And then we kind of complain about
the
plan.
Yeah, we come to
right.
in November, we say, hey, what are we doing?
But I think the new world, and it's going to continue to change, is real-time planning.
Right.
Right. Right. You're making decisions on a daily basis, and so you need information to be able to help support those decisions, and that's what we do. And we try to move companies from that old historical way mm-hmm. of looking at planning to the new way. You know, you just mentioned a CPG company, packaging company.
Right.
They're big customers of ours, CPG, retail, and why? I mean, they're all dealing with, the ability to kind of have online sales in 24 hours.
Right.
I mean, my own personal example, on Thanksgiving morning, I put in an order with one of the large retailers right. Here in the U.S., and I was amazed. The next morning, Friday morning, it was at the doorstep. Right? And that's not Amazon. We know that Amazon
right.
could do that. Now
right.
the others. So everyone's really trying to compete with that. And having insight as to what's going to be ordered, how they're going to deliver it,
right.
what's in the whole supply chain is critical. And that's why we're seeing cosmetic companies, beverage companies, spirit companies. They're all using Anaplan across their supply chain, which is great.
Now, when they use Anaplan, do they budget to trend, so to speak? If they've had a couple of bad 4 days, would their lines in Anaplan show that they've got to be worried for about a potential shortfall?
Well, they can, and they could also do some what-ifs, right? That's a big
right.
part. We have modeling capabilities. So
right.
what if a different mix of product happens like next week, right in the middle of the holiday season, if they had a look at some different trends after the first 2 weeks, and they had to then change that. How do they then modify their supply chain based on that new information to ensure that at the whether it's online or at the retail outlets, they have what they need to meet the necessary demand.
You know, I was thinking when I was reading it. Now, unfortunately, I wish I were being facetious. I've been on many, worked with many companies. And I was thinking that a criteria now that I should be asking these people is, do you do this kind of what I would be dynamic planning? Because if they don't, then they come to the board meeting, the boards of directors are shocked, and it's already too late.
Right. And it's exactly, that's exactly the problem. So, as you know, I've spent my whole career in the planning space.
Sure.
So I've lived through different phases of this evolution. You know, I'm a strong proponent now. I think over the next 5 years, 10 years, there's going to be a dramatic shift, and we're starting to see that, and really what's happening in planning. And we're talking about, you know, companies that are, you know, 50 years old and older that are making that pivot. And I think digitization, as I said before, is one of the key drivers.
Now, you work closely with Salesforce. So how would you integrate what they see their salespeople doing with what the top guys do about their plan?
Oh, it's perfect. I mean,
it is, right?
Most of our customers, you know, high percent, I'm saying way over, right, you know, 90%. Are using Salesforce, and they're also using Anaplan. We actually have our tab in Salesforce because you do all your CRM,
right,
and then you pull Anaplan in to do some of your other modeling, and it's very integrated, which is perfect.
I wish everyone who watched had a chance to be in business, because you would know that this is a blessing to have an Anaplan. I would be able to say at a board meeting, guys, will you just get this thing, because you really don't have a clue about what you're doing.
I just wish I had it 5 years ago or 10 years ago. I was doing some of the things
I
in the companies
too.
I was
businesses
part of.
Businesses that I've run.
But
it's remarkable. Anyway, this is an indispensable product that didn't exist, and an indispensable man who's been in a lot of great places. That's Frank Calderoni, the chairman and CEO of Anaplan. Again, always very transparent, lots of great stuff. You can learn about it even from the earnings call from November 21st. Very insightful. Mad Money's back after the break.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag mad tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.